Love Under Inspection Novel Audiobook. Chapter 1 to Chapter. When Gu Annuan left DFO Investment Bank, she felt dizzy. The stack of documents in her hands felt like a ton of rocks that made her gasp for breath. Before she knew it, a Maserati Gran Cabrio came right at her. The speeding car almost ran into her knees. Gu Annuan furrowed her brows and narrowed her eyes. She knew who the driver was. It was Lan Xuan Xuan, the new supermodel in town. Recently, it was rumored that she was dating Lu Xiu Jian. Lan Xuan Xuan came out of the car and swept her gaze over Gu Annuan. She gave her a cold smile. "Mistress Lu, I'm pregnant. The baby belongs to Xiu Jian." Gu Annuan stared at her. Lan Xuan Xuan was in her 20s and had thick, dramatic makeup on. Her red lips were complemented by the newest Align skirt by D brand. It showed off her curvaceous body perfectly. She also had a sexy bright purple fur coat on. "Well, Lu Xiu Jian's taste is really unpredictable." Gu Annuan didn't say anything and gave her a wide berth. Lan Xuan Xuan was visibly anxious and blocked her with her arms. "Mistress Lu, do you think it's a boy or a girl? What do you think I should name the baby? What comes after the surname Lu? Xiu Jian is with me every night. It must feel bad to be alone at night, right?"
"Mistress Lu, you didn't drive. Where are you going? I can give you a lift. You can sit in my new car that Xiu Jian bought for 3.2 million.
Lan Xuan Xuan said. She flipped her long hair to show off her sparkling pearl earrings. Gu Annuan recognized the earrings. They were made of Akoya pearls and customized by a famous brand. The price was 8.4 million. She knew that because of the receipt she found in Lu Xiujian's pocket a few days ago. Lu Xiujian was generous to his lovers. But he was heartless and merciless to her and the Gu family. "Xiu Jian treats me well and buys me everything I asked for.
Mistress Lu, I heard it was your birthday 2 days ago. What did Xiu Jian buy for you?"
Lan Xuan Xuan smiled smugly as she stared at the pearl necklace around Gu Annuan's neck. "That pearl necklace. I picked that out a month ago and got bored with it. So, he gave it to you."
Gu Annuan straightened her back. "Are you done?"
"Gu Annuan, why are you still hogging the position of Mistress Lu? From what I gather, Xiu Jian doesn't love you at all. He married you in the first place because of your family's status. Now that your family is in trouble, you are useless to him."
Since Gu Annuan looked indifferent, Lan Xuan Xuan went all out.
"You should take the hint and divorce Xiu Jian so I can marry him. Don't make the matter worse."
Gu Annuan lowered her gaze as her lips curled up into a cold smile.
"Miss Lan, since my husband loves you so much, you can ask him to divorce me. Why are you here instead?"
I,
Lan Xuan Xuan was rendered speechless. She had been pestering Lu Xiu Jian for at least 6 months, pleading and begging him for a divorce. Even though the man seemed to pamper her in every way possible, he wouldn't agree to her request. He was a man of great depth. What else could she do? Gu Annuan couldn't be bothered and continued walking. Suddenly, she stopped and turned. "By the way, I think there's something that you don't know. When I married my husband, we signed a prenup. He said that he will love me forever. If we get a divorce, he won't take a single cent from both the Gu and Lu families. He'll be left with nothing." Her words sent Lan Xuan Xuan into a shocked silence. Gu Annuan beckoned at her with her fingers. "All his assets will be mine, including the Maserati and pearl earrings he gifted to you." She turned and left. However, she could still hear Lan Xuan Xuan cursing behind her back.
"Gu Annuan, who do you think you are? Xiu Jian married you because he was mad at Miss Bo."
Gu Annuan's fists clenched and the papers in her hands crumpled. She had just turned a corner when her phone started ringing.
"Where are you?" Lu Xiu Jian's cold and grim voice was heard over the phone, like a dark glow in the night.
Gu Annuan's heart instantly tightened when she heard his voice.
"Come back. I've something to discuss with you." Before Gu Annuan could formulate a reply, he had already hung up. 8 years, they were together for 8 years and had been married for six. She married him happily and thought she got what she had always wanted. Gu Annuan couldn't remember since when their relationship became this strained. During the 6 years of their marriage, Lu Xiujian had plenty of lovers. He was intimate with each of them but remained a stranger to his wife. He wasn't like this back then. 6 years ago, he pampered her a lot. He even risked his life to save her from the huge fire. The scar was still visible on his arm. What had happened to them as husband and wife? Was Lan Xuanxuan right? Did he marry her just to make Bo Wan mad? Gu Annuan stood still for a while before pocketing her phone. She hailed a taxi and headed to the Liu family's villa in the suburbs. When she reached, a Porsche was parked in the courtyard. It was Lu Xiujian's car. He was already home. Gu Annuan had barely stepped in when a stack of bills was flung at her face. A total of 6.5 million was transferred out last month. Gu Annuan, I want an explanation from you today. Her mother-in-law was seated on the sofa. Her voice was icy as she reprimanded Gu Annuan. Although our family is wealthy and Xiujian earns a lot of money, how could you spend that much? Tell me, where did all the money go? Zheng Yadan yelled at her. Gu Annuan frowned and picked up the bills on the ground. She flipped through them and realized the said account belonged to Lu Xiujian. The card was given to her when they got married. However, she had stopped using the card since finding out about his affairs 5 years ago. Back then, her family was still wealthy. She had her own dignity. Even though her family needed money, she still maintained her dignity. The card was left in her bedside drawer until it went missing 2 months ago. She thought it was Lu Xiujian who took it. But now, Gu Annuan swept her gaze around the room and settled on Lu Xiujian's sister, Lu Jiayi. A look flashed across Lu Jiayi's face. She averted her glance and cuddled up to Zheng Yadan. Mom, do you even need to hear her explanation? It's obvious that she transferred the money to her family because they are in trouble right now. The Gu family. Their family owes other people 200 million. You should let Xiujian divorce her as soon as possible. Our family wouldn't be able to pay for her actions. She's Miss Gu, the most famous socialite in Jin City. What kind of socialite would steal from others so shamelessly? Lu Jiayi was scornful. Wan is so much better than her. After her grandfather's promotion, their status is more prominent now. If Xiujian married Bo Wan back then, our family would have moved up on the social ladder. We wouldn't be in this state. Lu Jiayi, are you done? Gu Annuan took a step forward and gave her an icy stare. If you are done, shut up. Lu Jiayi immediately shut up. She felt guilty and dared not go against Gu Annuan. So she curled up in Zheng Yadan's arms and complained. Mom, she scolded me. Bo Wan wouldn't scold me for sure. Zheng Yadan tightened her arms around Lu Jiayi and stared at Gu Annuan coldly. Gu Annuan, enough. Gu Annuan straightened her back and looked at Zheng Yadan straight in the eyes. She said in earnest, Mom, I didn't take the money. If it wasn't you, who else would it be? Could it be me? Could it be Jiayi? Do you think I'm old and senile now? Xiujian gave you this card when you were married. Zheng Yadan yelled. The person who took the money would know. Gu Annuan gave Lu Jiayi a cold look. Mom, if you don't believe me, you can make a police report and get the CCTV recordings from the bank to find out the truth. Lu Jiayi was visibly frightened. You can't call the police. Your family is already in prison. Are you going to cause chaos in our family too? Let me tell you, you'd better repay the money you took or I'll ask my brother to divorce you. Divorce? An icy voice spoke up from behind. Gu Annuan turned and saw Lu Xiujian standing at the end of the stairway with a wine glass in his hand. He had a white and crisp shirt on. The man was still elegant and handsome like he was 8 years ago. But the dark look on his face was the polar opposite. His sleeves were rolled up and the top of his shirt was unbuttoned. His visible collarbone was still sexy as usual. Time didn't leave any mark on his face, but made his body sexy and mature instead. Gu Annuan knew that even though right now Lu Xiujian was only clad in slippers, plenty of women would line up and offer themselves to him. Lu Jiayi was afraid of Lu Xiujian. She immediately hid behind Zheng Yadan. Whether Nuan and I get a divorce is none of your business. Lu Xiujian walked down the stairs and glared at Lu Jiayi. Zheng Yadan stretched her arms wide and stood in front of Lu Jiayi. She forced a smile and said, "Xiujian, this is Jiayi's fault. Annuan was the one who transferred 6.5 million from your account but wouldn't admit it. I was the one who did it." Lu Xiujian couldn't be bothered to argue with them. His words immediately shut them all up. "Xiujian, you..." Zheng Yadan was going to say something but stopped after seeing Lu Xiujian's angry glare. She was only his stepmother and couldn't discipline him. Lu Jiayi lowered her head guiltily behind Zheng Yadan. Lu Xiujian turned and grabbed Gu Annuan's wrist. A glint flashed across his hazel eyes as he said, "Come upstairs with me. I have something to tell you." When Gu Annuan was in DFO, she had fallen down and bruised her wrist. Lu Xiujian was pressing at her wound tightly. The pain she felt almost brought tears to her eyes. She clenched her teeth and forced the tears back. Gu Annuan was brought into a room by Lu Xiujian, who then locked the door. He was furious. "Did you make Lan Xuanxuan angry?" Gu Annuan furrowed her brows. The grateful feeling she had felt a minute ago disappeared into thin air. "Your lover complained because I was being sarcastic to her." "It's you?" Lu Xiujian's face darkened. "Yes, it's me. I told her you have plenty of lovers out there. You don't care about her and was just playing around." Gu Annuan sneered. She wasn't thinking of explaining properly as he wouldn't believe her. "You must be crazy." Lu Xiujian lifted her up in a fit of anger. Gu Annuan could feel his fury. She glowered at him and scoffed. "Lu Xiujian, throw me down. Kill me and pretend it was a suicide so you can dissociate from the Gu family's trouble." Her words infuriated Lu Xiujian immensely. The man's arms froze for a minute before throwing her onto the soft bed. Gu Annuan laid in the bed and said, "Mr. Lu, so you know murder is against the law, or you couldn't bring yourself to kill me." "I don't think so. You have so many lovers out there." Lu Xiujian tugged at his tie and took off his blazer. He abruptly stood over her and tore her dress apart violently. His huge palms started stroking her thighs. Gu Annuan was shocked and immediately struggled. Lu Xiujian's hazel pupils dilated as his lips curled up in a mocking smile. He stopped his actions and lifted her chin threateningly. "This is a warning. Stay away from Lan Xuanxuan." "How ridiculous," Gu Annuan thought as she stared at the man blankly. Lu Xiujian stood up and tidied his clothes. He took out another card from his pocket and threw it at her. "This is a new card. Mom and Jiayi don't know about it. Next time, you can transfer money to the Gu family through this card." Gu Annuan's heart sank in despair. She thought he trusted her back then. But, just like Zheng Yadan, he thought she took the money from the account. In the past, Lu Xiujian would trust her completely. But the man scared her now. Gu Annuan laughed coldly and took the card from him. She opened the door to the bathroom and threw the card in the toilet before flushing it away. Lu Xiujian stared at her coldly. "You are crazy." "Yes. A crazy person like me wouldn't want money from the Lu family." Qin Yuan shrugged and said, "Mr. Lu, does your little lover know that you are this generous to me?" Lu Xiujian furrowed his brows in disgust. Gu Annuan continued sneering. "Mr. Lu, my family needs 200 million. You might as well be more generous by divorcing me so Lu Group will end up mine. I can use the money to pay the debt." "Divorce?" Lu Xiujian's face fell. "Gu Annuan, don't even think about it. The prenup was too valuable. Gu Annuan knew he wouldn't agree to a divorce. Even if he did, she wouldn't divorce him now and taint the Gu family's name. Lu Xiujian tidied his shirt and was going to head out when a thought flashed across his mind. I already have a date for tomorrow's charity dinner. You don't have to come along. Gu Annuan was rendered speechless. She wanted to retort back, but realized her words were powerless. Her father's huge 200 million debt caused him to lose his position. The whole Jin City was gossiping about him. Many influential people would be attending the charity dinner tomorrow. Perhaps it was too embarrassing for him to bring her there. However, she heard that someone from the central government will be there tomorrow. It could be related to her father's case. So she had to be there. Gu Annuan was a proud woman and wouldn't beg for Lu Xiujian's help now. The only thing she could do was to text her best friend, Qiao Chuchu. An hour later, Gu Annuan's car stopped in front of Sultry Knight's door. She alighted from the car in a hurry. After throwing the keys to the valet, she rushed into the club. Qiao Chuchu had already ordered their drinks. She was dressed in a sexy outfit that sparkled under the club's neon lights. Nguyen, come here and sit beside me. It's rare that you ask me out. We'll have fun tonight. She excitedly pushed a glass of Long Island iced tea forward. Gu Annuan smiled wryly and sat down opposite her. Qiao Chuchu continued. Hey, do you remember this? It was what you drank on your wedding night. When you married Lu Xiujian. I made this drink for you. How was it? It must be an exhilarating night, right? Gu Annuan's lips curled up in an awkward smile. The words were stuck in her throat and she couldn't say a word. She didn't know how to tell Chu Chu that nothing happened that night. Of course, that wasn't the only night they didn't have sex. They never had sex for the past 6 years after their wedding. Chu Chu, I won't drink. You should stop drinking too because you'll get drunk. Gu Annuan knew what had happened. Huo Chengyun was about to get engaged. But his fiancée wasn't Chu Chu. She was upset and kept drinking to numb the pain in her heart. Nguyen, alcohol is great. You can forget all the unhappy things after getting drunk. Qiao Chuchu's forced smile disappeared in an instant. It's a pity I drink too well. No amount of alcohol can make me drunk. Gu Annuan opened her mouth to console her. But when she thought of her own circumstances, nothing came out of her mouth. Her situation was worse than Chu Chu. At least her friend's parents were still alive and didn't need to worry about money. But she. Qiao Chuchu finished her drink. The coldness cleared her mind. She immediately fished out an invitation from her clutch and gave it to Gu Annuan. Here's the invitation to the charity dinner that you asked for. Gu Annuan was stunned. Where did you get this from? The charity dinner was an exclusive event. When Gu Annuan texted Qiao Chuchu, she didn't have much hope. Qiao Chuchu's parents were divorced. Her mother married into the Huo family and took her along. It might seem that her family was wealthy now, but she was merely a parasite living under the Huo family's roof. Gu Annuan wanted to use the Huo family's connections to get into the event or at least a spot to wait outside the venue. But Qiao Chuchu gave her the invitation directly. I stole it from Hua Chengyun. Qiao Chuchu scoffed, her seductive red lips curling up in a sneer. He has a pretty and rich fiancée. Their family would form a strong alliance together. Why does he need to join the charity dinner? To get to know more rich and powerful people. He doesn't need that. Gu Annuan's face fell and she gave the invitation back to her. Chu Chu, take it back. I don't want to affect your relationship with Hua Chengyun. Nguyen, what am I to Hua Chengyun? We aren't related at all. He's getting married and I'm pissed at that fact. So this is my revenge. Nguyen, you'll help me, right? Gu Annuan immediately knew what was going on. The Huo family must be thinking of introducing Hua Chengyun's fiancée at the charity dinner tomorrow. Hence Chu Chu was pissed off. Chu Chu. Thank you. Gu Annuan took the invitation. I'll keep it. Take care. Qiao Chuchu broke into a smile. Don't worry. I'm still his sister officially. He can't hurt me. Gu Annuan could only smile awkwardly at her. Qiao Chuchu was Hua Chengyun's stepsister. Although he was decisive and merciless, he wouldn't do anything to hurt his stepsister. Nguyen, Lu Xiujian should also be invited to the charity dinner tomorrow. Won't he bring you along? Qiao Chuchu sobered up a little and asked in confusion. Something pricked at Gu Annuan's eyes. She couldn't bring herself to say that he already had a date. Instead, she chuckled and said, Xiujian left on a business trip this morning and couldn't make it in time for the dinner tomorrow. The invitation is with him. Actually, he wanted to bring me there but he really wasn't free to. Oh, I see. I thought you two had a fight. Qiao Chuchu chortled and continued drinking. Gu Annuan could feel an ache expanding in her chest. After texting Hua Chengyun secretly, she stood up and said, Chuchu, I need to leave now. No, how can you leave so soon? Nguyen, how can you do this to me? Qiao Chuchu pursed her lips. Lu Xiujian is at home. Why do you need to hurry back? To meet your secret love. Oh, by the way, do you know that our senior from college? Fu, senior Fu is back. Chuchu, stop joking. Gu Annuan put on a stern front. She was brought up very strictly. The Gu family wasn't bothered about money, but they cared about their reputation the most. Words like secret lover were a taboo to them. Qiao Chuchu dropped her smile. Nguyen, I'm sorry. I must be drunk. Gu Annuan could see that her cheeks were flushed red. She was afraid something might happen to Qiao Chuchu. So she stayed with her until a tall figure strode toward them. The man was obviously Hua Chengyun. She immediately grabbed her bag and left. Meanwhile, a Rolls-Royce Phantom was parked in front of Sultry Night. The secretary, Shen Yue, who was in the driver's seat, turned and asked the man seated behind, Mr. Fu, Mr. Huo just left the car. Should we return to the villa now? Fu Siye was seated on the cozy, slate gray sheepskin seat with his legs crossed. Half of his face was hidden by the newspaper in his hands. His gaze was focused on the familiar license plate outside the window and the figure who was walking toward it. When he heard Shen Yu's voice, his fingers that were clutching the newspaper tightened slightly. The man snorted and wound up the window immediately. Gu Annuan was still wearing the smoky gray suit she put on that afternoon. In her hands was a bright red invitation card. Fu Siye's lips curled up in a smile and his gaze darkened slightly. He put down the newspaper and told Shen Yue, get a bouquet of roses from Rosian Li for Miss Bo. Invite her to the charity dinner, tomorrow is my date. What? Shen Yue was shocked. But Mr. Fu's official image is that of a man who is out of touch with reality and women. What is he going to do now? You don't understand my orders. Fu Siye raised his head and narrowed his eyes dangerously. Yes, Mr. Fu. Shen Yue dared not ask any more. Fu Siye's eyes gazed outside without a word. No one could understand what he was thinking about. Perhaps his gaze was too intense. As Gu Annuan could feel an insurmountable pressure of someone's eyes on her. When she turned, the smoky gray phantom had gone by in a flash. The moment she saw the car, the license plate felt immensely familiar to her. It was so familiar that she felt a stabbing pain in her heart. Impossible. He abandoned her 8 years ago and she had not heard from him since then. It had been 8 years. He would probably be married with kids now. Gu Annuan's lips curled up in a bitter smile. She was afraid her heart would ache more if she continued thinking about him. So she hurriedly got into her car. The next afternoon, Gu Annuan changed into a tight-fitting lilac dress. She pulled her hair up in a bun and put on light makeup in preparation for the dinner. She was taking out a choker necklace from her jewelry box when she accidentally knocked over a small box lying beside. A vintage men's watch slipped out from the box and fell onto the ground. Yi was engraved on the back of the gray watch strap. Gu Annuan was slightly stunned and immediately knelt down to pick it up. She realized that there was a tie, a pair of cufflinks and an old notebook inside the box as well. Her memories came flooding back. The man's smiles and actions from 8 years ago flashed across her mind again and again. 6 years ago, when Gu Annuan married Lu Xiujian, the box went missing. For the past 6 years, she had searched for it high and low but couldn't find it. When she was on the verge of giving up, the box was found. It turned out that the maid had kept it in the deepest end of the storage box. Footsteps were heard from outside the door. Gu Annuan knew it must be Lu Xiujian. She panicked and picked up the things that had fallen to the floor in a flurry and stashed the box back to its original spot. Just as she closed the drawer, Lu Xiujian entered. You are back. Gu Annuan stammered as her fingers trembled slightly. Lu Xiujian harrumphed and swept his gaze over her. A look of confusion flashed across his hazel eyes. The man frowned and asked, "Why are you all dressed up? Didn't I tell you I already have a date for tonight? You won't be coming with me." Gu Annuan calmed herself down before replying with a forced smile, "Mr. Lu, stop flattering yourself. I'm not one who is at your beck and call. I never wanted to attend the charity dinner with you." Lu Xiujian didn't argue with her and narrowed his gaze. "Remember not to drink as you are going out alone. None of your business." Gu Annuan scoffed. "Mr. Lu, you drink when you are with your lover. Right? If you can't do it, don't force me to do it too." Lu Xiujian glanced at her, seemingly speechless at her retort. He opened his mouth to say something but ended up not saying anything. He put down the folder in his hands and loosened his tie. The blazer and shirt that he wore reeked of alcohol and cigarette smoke. After he took those off, he discarded them into the bin, striding over to his closet. The man took out another shirt that was exactly the same and put it on. Gu Annuan stared at him with furrowed brows. To be honest, Lu Xiujian was blessed with a great figure. Even if he was wearing a cheap suit, it would look expensive on him. "You have good taste. Help me choose a tie that goes with my shirt." Lu Xiujian was standing in front of the full-length mirror. He straightened the collar and rolled up his sleeves while ordering her in a lazy voice. In the past, Gu Annuan would just ignore him. But since she was in a hurry to attend the charity dinner and didn't want to waste time quarreling with him, she opened his closet and chose the tie with the simplest design among his collection. Lu Xiujian narrowed his eyes. There was still a hint of a smile on his face as he stretched his arms open to let her put it around him. He was extremely tall and purposely lowered himself. But Gu Annuan still had to stand on tiptoes to help him put on the tie. Her nose nearly touched his jaw. The smile on Lu Xiujian's face was still there. Anyone watching them would think that they were a loving couple. After Gu Annuan was done, she stepped back anxiously. "Looks great." Lu Xiujian looked at his reflection in the mirror and chuckled. "Nuan, you are talented in fashion. If you hadn't changed your major back then, you'd be a famous designer by now." A shiver swept through Gu Annuan's body. She looked calm but something flashed across her face. Lu Xiujian managed to stab her heart with just a few words. "Your taste is still the same, Mr. Lu. Bo Wan was a famous designer in Milan. Most importantly, she was Lu Xiujian's unforgettable first love. Funnily enough, they were classmates back in university. Bo Wan's designs were always placed second as the first place always belonged to Gu Annuan. Her famous embroidery work, The End of Spring, won the first prize of an international design contest. Everyone in Jin City University thought Gu Annuan would leave the country and become the most famous Chinese designer worldwide. But in her second year, she changed her major to finance abruptly. From that day onward, she was no longer a designer. No one knew why she did that. Gu Annuan could feel her eyes pricking as if sen had gotten into her eyes. She turned and headed for the door. "Tonight, officials from our district will be there too. We haven't made a decision about the land in the south of the city, so I might be late. Be careful. You can ask Li to drive you since I won't be free. Lu Xiujian opened the closet while he was talking and saw a box that had moved from its position in the corner. The smile that was at the corner of his mouth disappeared instantly. He chose a watch from his collection with a cold look on his face. The folder that was in his hands was thrown right beside the box before he shut the closet door with a loud bang. Downstairs in the living room, Lu Jiayi was eating fruits when Lu Xiujian came down. She frowned and immediately complained. Xiujian, did she lose her temper at you again? I saw her going out in a huff. She ignored me when I called her. Lu Xiujian frowned and went out without another word. Hey, why are you ignoring me too? Xiujian, Lu Jiayi was a little short of money recently. She had been waiting in the living room for almost an hour, planning to get some pocket money from her brother and sister-in-law, but her plan failed. Lu Jiayi was throwing away the fruit peel in her hands when her phone began ringing. Miss Lu, do you still want the product? Didn't you say it was for Liang's birthday present? If you are not paying for it, then I'll take it. No. Lu Jiayi frowned and glanced at the empty stairways. Her gaze trailed to the empty master bedroom on the second floor. Of course, I want it. I'll pay no matter how expensive it is. Thanks for listening to the Bravonovel audiobook. Welcome to download the Bravonovel app. Read the novel Love Under Inspection online and get the latest updates. Please see the video introduction for the novel details page and app download address.